Should have been a cowboy. I should have learned to rope and ride. Wearing my six shooter, riding my pony on a cattle drive. Steal every young girl's hearts, just like Gene and Roy, singing those campfire songs. Oh, I should have been a cowboy. Hey guys, I should have been a cow gal or whatever. This is Alachia, and this is my review for Hell or High Water. Woohoo! Look at this. See, a gal can learn trigger discipline here. See, so that works. This is just a BB gun, by the way, but there's something about wearing a cowboy hat and holding a fake BB gun pistol-ish thing that just feels so Texas. Yeah, so this is a movie that was directed by David McKenzie and written by Taylor Sheridan, who also wrote Cesario, and it stars Chris Pine, Jeff Bridges, and Ben Foster. There are these two brothers, Toby and Tanner Howard, played by Chris Pine and Ben Foster. One of them is just a divorced guy, lives out in a ranch, and he teams up with his brother, who's played by Ben Foster, who is an ex-con, you know, and they go around robbing these, you know, banks out in Midland, Texas, or out in Midland Banks out in Midwest Texas. I mean, you're talking towns that are population 30, 50-ish. And of course, you have Jeff Bridges' character, who's the Texas Ranger, who kind of gets assigned to the case, and he is being forced into retirement because he's kind of getting older in his age. And so he sort of pursues this case a little bit harder than he normally would because it's kind of his last case. He's only got a couple more weeks on the job. And so he's kind of like going after these two brothers who are going around robbing a bunch of banks. Now, this sounds like a pretty straightforward type movie, but what I really, really enjoyed about it was, one, it stays so true to a very kind of Southwest culture. Very, very Texas. It's so Texas it hurts. Second, it's a smart heist film. I mean, it is about two kind of, you know, rednecks, but their plan is solid. I mean, the reasoning behind their plan, you can kind of think of it as like Inside Man. That's a really great, another great heist film where it's not just the heist, but it's the reasoning behind the heist, which makes the film a little bit more intriguing. It really brings a lot of character to Toby and Tanner Howard, who are the two brothers who are going around robbing the banks. And it gives you a great perspective as to why they're doing what they're doing. The differences between the two characters, you know, one being the very smart kind of mastermind of the plan and the other one just being kind of this trigger happy guy who's just very prone to criminal activity anyway, and just sort of seeing the dynamic of the two and the situation in which they're sort of forced to kind of like pursue this, you know, these criminal acts that they're doing. And then of course Jeff Bridges' character, who is so deeply Southern, so deeply Texas, he has this partner played by Gil Birmingham, and named Alberto. He's like half Mexican, half Indian. And of course there's these kind of insults that Jeff Bridges continually throws at him in kind of like a loving jest, kind of playing with him. And there's this relationship that sort of forms between those two as well. So there's like these two character dynamics between, you know, all four characters. And I just really enjoyed sort of seeing that play out. It was very well written. Very, very well written. And I enjoyed the direction of it. And I really enjoyed Chris Pine and Ben Foster's, you know, work. Ben Foster, having played Medivh this past, you know, summer in Warcraft, I just did not like that performance. But here, I mean, this was a solid, just grade A performance from him. And Chris Pine, who I just really disliked in, you know, Star Trek Beyond, mainly because I don't like the direction in which they're taking, you know, Captain Kirk in that to see him sort of play this lone cowboy type, it was done so well. I mean, down to the, like, the long, greasy hair and kind of his Southern reclusiveness, and just it was done so well, and I related to all the characters extremely well, even though obviously, you know, I'm not in their situation, but the way that it was written is that you could really get behind all these characters' motivations. So I just thought it was so intriguing, and I'm gonna actually do spoilers for this one because there's so many things I want to talk about that I just like, I was like, yes, I loved all these parts of the films, in the film, and I want to talk about them. So I'm gonna go into spoilers after I give the grade, and the grade is an A. I just, wow, yes. Texas pride all the way, but mostly not just because it's in Texas, although they did a really, really great job representing Midwest Texas, but because of the scripting, because of the way in which they kind of told the story, although it has a little bit of kind of, you know, you can kind of tell where the story's going. There's no surprises. It's not like, oh gosh, you know, like what's the big surprise? What's the big aha? It definitely unfolds like very easily, and there's no twist at the end or anything like that. So it's kind of extremely, you know, you can predict what's going on, but it's just done so well that you really enjoy the story and the ride that it sort of takes you on. All right, so let me get into spoilers here. So spoilers, 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 spoilers. All right, okay, so man. So like I said, this is about two brothers, one named Toby Howard and the other named Tanner. Their mom gets sick, you know, over the course of, you know, I don't know, the latter parts of her life. And you kind of get the idea that they're on this ranch and they probably had to do a bunch of loans to take care of her. Toby had to take care of her because Tanner was off in jail. And you find out later that the father kind of beat them. And then Tanner, who is played by Ben Foster, went to jail for 10 years because he shot his dad in a hunting accident in the barn. So you kind of get the gist of like where these characters are coming from. Toby being more of the kind of straightforward, honest character who took care of his mom, and Tanner being just someone who's just like, you know, I take care of business, I'm more prone to crime, he has robbed banks in the past. So they must have racked up a couple, you know, a bunch of like bills and had to take a double mortgage on the ranch, and they had owed back taxes and a bunch of stuff. There's going to be a foreclosure on the ranch. Now here's the cool part. There's oil on this land that they own in the ranch, and their plan is basically to get the money back, you know, from the bank, you know, to pay the money back to the bank and secure a trust on that land. So they create a trust, and then it can't be sold. That land can't be sold, and he can pass that land off to his sons. So he has two sons from his previous wife, and he wants to secure this for them. That's his only thing. He's been poor his whole life. There's now this chance for them to never have to worry about money, for his kids to never have to worry about money, not for him, for his kids, and he's pursuing that. And I just thought that was such a seriously, like, honest, you know, integral, like, kind of characteristic that was just really great about the movie. And here's the thing. They weren't just going to rob any bank. They are robbing the banks that put those foreclosures on their land, that created those loans that they knew that they couldn't pay back, that there was no possible way they could pay back. So they are going specifically after the Midland, Texas banks, and they're only robbing the cash in the drawers. They're not robbing any of the stuff in the back that's inked or marked. And so that's why they have to rob a series of banks, a couple of banks at a time, to secure about $40,000. That's it. That's all they need to sort of buy that land and secure the trust. And so it's great because they are stealing from the banks and then using that money to actually give back to the banks to pay, you know, to pay off their foreclosure so that they don't, you know, get foreclosed. And the way that they do this, so they rob the cash out of the banks, which is, it's great, you know, just the cash, the petty cash, about 10 to 20 grand at a time. And then they go to casinos and they take the cash and they give, you know, the cash to the casino clerk. The casino clerk gives them a bunch of chips, and then they go off pretending like, you know, they're going to go spend that money. And they go to another teller at the end of the night, return those chips, and have a check made out to Midland, Texas Bank. So it was a really good, clean, smart idea that I really appreciated about, like, the way that they pursued, you know, this stuff. And it wasn't about greed. It wasn't about having so much money so they could buy boats and cars. It was just about paying off that loan and securing a trust on that land for his children. And I just was like, wow, that's great. That is so smart. And, you know, the rights to the oil that they're going to be drilling on that land will give those kids like 50 grand a month, you know. So it was just funny because they're stealing $40,000, but they're going to end up getting $50,000 a month, you know, off of the land. And the pursuit of this was just like really fun to watch unfold. And yeah, it's predictable, you know, because they kind of explain it in the beginning, exactly what they're planning to do, how they're planning to do it. Jeff Bridges' character kind of goes up against them, tries to figure out what they're doing, goes up against them. And of course, there is this conflict between the brother, the more wild, you know, criminal brother, Tanner, who's played by Ben Foster, who is great. He's just so wild. He's kind of just, whoa, I'll do whatever it takes, you know, like, yippee-ki-yay, motherfuckers. He carries around this automatic weapon, which his brother's just like, no, I don't want anything to do with those fucking, like, automatic weapons, pistols only, you know. And, of course, here's the thing about Texas, which is great, is I've always told Azixim, don't piss anyone off in Texas. Please don't. I know you could do this in Boston and everything, but don't do it in Texas because everyone here carries a gun. Like, you just don't want to piss people off here because there is a chance they may whip out a gun and shoot you. And that is a very real thing. And it is so funny because there's a point where they actually have to rob a more mid-sized bank, right? And they don't want to do this. They've always been very smart robbing banks before anyone shows up. And so there's no customers. And they always try to rob towns of, like, you know, population 50. So there's, like, no one's going to be at the bank. At the end, they're sort of forced to, like, rob a larger bank to secure the rest of the money. So they go in and they're like, you know, stick them up, motherfuckers. And the entire bank is full of people just waiting in line. And so, of course, they rob the banks. And as soon as they, like, run out of the bank, everyone and their mother pulls out their gun and goes after them. It's just like, oh, no, man, you're not going to rob our bank. You know, they go after them. They take their trucks and they just chase after them, all vigilante justice and stuff. And I just felt like that may seem ridiculous to a lot of people, especially in any culture where guns are not very prevalent. But it's so the case here. Like, if you were to do something here where you did something publicly that was wrong, like you went out and you snatched a purse or you snatched something really fast, which is what happens a lot in inner cities, here you just won't see that. You don't have to protect your baggage as much as other places. There's no snatching grabs because vigilante justice here is a little bit stronger than in other places. And I just love that it was sort of reflected in that movie. I don't know why. I don't normally see it that often in movies because, you know, I guess there's not that many Deep South sort of cultural movies. And so to see that was just like, yeah, that's exactly what I've been trying to tell you. Like, you just don't fuck with people in Texas because you just never know, right? Just to protect yourself, don't piss anyone off. And so that was, like, really funny. And then, of course, there's another scene where there was this waitress, right? And they go to the sheriff, the ranger, Jeff Bridges' character, and his partner, Alberto, go into this, you know, completely small town place with only one restaurant, and they only serve steak and potatoes. And the waitress is like, what don't you want? And we've been open since 1977, and all we serve is steak and potatoes. Except for this one time this guy tried to order, 1987, tried to order trout. Now, we don't serve trout in this joint. It's like, so either you don't want corn on the cob, or you don't want green beans. And it's just like, you know, basically a one-step order type thing. And she's just like, okay, so you want iced tea? And then, of course, Alberto's character's like, I'll have a No, iced tea's fine. Iced tea's fine. And again, it's just one of these things where, like, if you've been in a small town and you've been into these, like, one restaurant towns, you know what it's like. You know, it's very, it feels so very familiar to me. And I just, again, it's just kind of fun to see that, you know, a kind of cultural reference that you get sort of reflected in the movie. Again, there was another joke about Mr. Piv versus Dr. Pepper and how only assholes drink Mr. Piv. And I was just like, I just enjoyed it because there's just so many things that I just thought were kind of funny, that kind of, you know, off the cuff funny for me because of cultural references. But also I enjoyed the actual storyline, the heist itself, the reasoning behind the heist, and then the sort of like kind of strong Southern cultural integrity that these boys had, you know, and that's something that I find that I kind of enjoy here living in the South, that I really have taken pride in, the kind of a Southern Texas pride. But at the same time, of course, I see, you know, the danger in it, obviously, this kind of stubbornness, this kind of ignorance that, you know, you kind of have going into things, just kind of thinking that you could blaze your way through certain things. But overall, it is kind of like a pride thing, and I really did enjoy it. I mean, just, I really, really enjoyed it. And I can't wait to share this with, you know, Isaacson, my best friend Flip, who didn't get to see it. But man, like, it is definitely one of those movies that I'm going to be recommending to people, especially if they like heist films. Now, it is a kind of a slow-running film, so that's the only thing that I would, you know, if people like a high-paced sort of film, this probably won't be a film for you. But for me, I just, man, this was grade A all the way. All right, guys, if you have seen Hell or High Water, let me know what you thought. Or if you don't really like Southern culture, I'd be interested in, I know a lot of people think that we're a little too prideful, you know, the whole don't mess with Texas stuff, you know, that's actually just a litter slogan campaign, anti-litter slogan campaign. But I know a lot of people have issues with the way that Texas can kind of be perceived, but we're pretty nice down here. We're pretty low going, slow going, mellow. It is changing, of course, but yeah. So anyways, if you have any things you want to say about Texas or questions, let me know. Or what you thought about Hell or High Water, if you did see it. And if you'd like to see more, you can click right here and watch my Blair Witch review, or you can click right here and watch my Sully review. Thanks for watching, guys. And until next time, see you on the flip side.